follow me, and I will take you in. Finally, you get to see what we think.
Singapore Youth Flying Club to experience first-hand flying, as I always wanted to be a pilot with the Air Force since I was young. I was looking forward to, yet extremely nervous for the interview as I had no idea what to expect. On the very same day, I was notified that I had passed the interview selections and I was beyond excited, couldn't wait to start flying. Thanks to Singapore Youth Flying Club, I was able to pursue my passion for flight and now I'm one step closer to fulfilling my childhood dreams.
The first time I heard about Youth Flying Club, I was very excited to get started with my applications in hope of becoming the next licensed pilot. We had to go through an interview as well as a medical test to ensure our fitness to fly. And after 2 long months of waiting, I made it and thus commenced my flying journey. This was when I realised the full challenge ahead, as we have to dedicate strong efforts and actions to put out a good show as a trainee.
Whole new experience for me. After dreaming of flying for so many years, I could finally make it a reality. But apart from flying itself, it gave me the opportunity to meet new people with the same ambitions and interests. At first, we stepped into the briefing room strangers from several different walks of life. But as the weeks go by, it didn't take long for us to forge close bonds after opening up to one another.
My journey at SYFC began with the basic flying course, which was important especially since I had no prior knowledge of aviation at all. Learning the basic principles of flight, then applying that theory to practice in such a short period of time, proved to be a challenge for many. However, this challenge was quickly overcome with the aid of the flight simulator, which helped us familiarize ourselves with the cockpit as well as the flight controls. Under the guidance of Mr. Hai, we benefited a lot from the sim sessions and it helped us feel more prepared for the actual flight.
My first sortie with SYFC was an eye-opener as it was my first flight seeing Singapore from a different perspective. Although I was extremely nervous for my first flight, my instructor guided me through pointing out important landmarks and ground reference points I needed to take note of. Overall, it was definitely an enjoyable and memorable flight and made me more excited and enthusiastic to get started with my subsequent sorties.
When I first started flying, it was very challenging to be able to listen out carefully for situation and manners and to fly the aircraft at the same time. It was hard to understand radio calls at first, especially when you are still new and not yet accustomed to constant cluttering radio call. Determining their whereabouts in the air while paying maximum concentration to fly in the aircraft set a new ball game as multitasking was a necessity. Thinking back, I believe that these challenges indeed provide great learning opportunities for us, allowing the realization of our potential and enable the overcoming of our fears, motivating us to achieve even greater goals.
The night before my first solo flight, I recall being immensely thrilled. The effort that I put into months of practice, trying to master the art of taking off and landing safely, were finally about to come to fruition. Indeed, my first solo flight was my most memorable, as never before had I ever felt so scared and yet so excited at the same time. It was my virgin experience having complete control of the aircraft, without the bolstering presence of my instructor beside me. The moment the aircraft touched down, I felt a sense of relief and accomplishment knowing that I achieved something I had long anticipated. It was truly an unforgettable experience that boosted my confidence in subsequent flying.
After my first solo landing, I had my celebratory first solo dunk done by my instructor Tan SL. I was very relieved to have completed my first solo flight successfully and felt a great sense of accomplishment as I put in 100% to every flight prior to my first solo and my efforts finally paid off. I was recommended by my instructor to continue my flying journey with a few of my course mates in the PPL phase.
Entering the PPL phase is a kind of feeling that I'll never forget. I got my flight suit on the same day after I cleared my first solo and proceeded into flying my first PPL flight the day after. I was delighted to have crossed over another milestone in my flying phase. Yet at the same time, I realized I have to put in greater effort to overcome advanced challenges set ahead of me.
In the PPL phase, there's much greater emphasis on precision of maneuvers, decision making, and executing the right task at the right moment. We moved on to more advanced circuits as glide, PFL, and were also introduced to instrument flying, steep turns, and emergency drills. I liked being in the simulator. Being in the air meant that everything had to be done correctly and promptly, and some mistakes could be potentially disastrous. Initially, the steep learning curve set me back. However, with the encouragement and advice from the instructors and alumni, I soon overcame those challenges.
Even as flying is an integral part of our PPL curriculum, learning the theory is also key because it gives us a greater understanding of aviation law, factors affecting our aircraft in flight, and also more about the aircraft itself. So during our PPL course, we have to take 6 examinations with the CAS, and in which we studied via the SYFC ground school. Though the journey was tough, it was really rewarding as we learned a lot more about flying, which helped us to refine our flying skills. And furthermore, by understanding more about what it takes to be a pilot, it also made flying much more meaningful.
The final handling test was definitely the most important flight in my entire SYFC journey. Preparation for this test was a tough one. For the flight segment, preparation started right from the very first sortie, and every flight was a learning process for me. For the ground briefs, preparation was equally challenging, but thankfully, I had my fellow PPL coursemates who studied and prepared with me, and this made it a lot more manageable. My fellow coursemates definitely made my journey in SYFC a very meaningful one, and it would never be complete without them.
During our PPL phase, we were slowly given more and more authority and control over the aircraft as we prepare for our final handling test. It became our responsibility to bring a tester out for our flight to complete a certain set of tasks safely. The feeling of it is a unique blend of excitement and anxiousness as we now bear a heavier responsibility in flying the aircraft safely by ourselves. All in all, the FHT sums up to be an amazing journey that is very rewarding and fulfilling, which developed me as a better person in many aspects.
In the days prior to my FHT, I often ask myself, am I up to it? Or am I fit to be the pilot in command? I felt really nervous and anxious. After 11 arduous months of training, I was finally about to get my license, and this was my big day. My FHT went pretty smoothly, and despite the bad weather, I managed to pass my FHT with flying colours. And I'm thankful to the SYFC staff for all the assistance given and lessons taught to me which got me through it.
After passing my FHT, it hit me that I was finally a graduate of YFC and alumni. It was my turn to impart my knowledge to the junior batches. When I was in VFC, my mentor played a huge role in motivating me to give it my all. Together with the other alumni, we try our best to come down for mentoring sessions to help the juniors with aircraft checks and ground procedures, so as to make their flying journey a smooth sailing one.
Having benefited so much from the flying program, I strongly feel that I have contributed back to SYFC. I feel a need to inspire other fellow trainee pilots with my experience and provide them with tips and tricks to assist them through the RDS training process. By doing this, not only do we benefit our new flying mates, we also get the opportunity to refresh and regain our flying currency so as not to lose touch in our passion in aviation.
My journey in SYFC has been a fulfilling and enriching one. It gave me an opportunity to have a taste of what flight is, and this reinforced my passion for flying. It also made me reaffirm my decision in joining the Air Force and pursue my flying career.
Learning to fly with SYFC has allowed me to fulfill my dreams of flight. Through flying, I've learned to make quick, critical and rational decisions, not just in the air but also on the ground.
Flying made me more responsible for my actions, and I'm able to handle stress better, learning to prioritize after the constant training multitasking. I learned to always have the right attitude and to always be positive, firm and confident, even in the face of challenges. SYFC gave me a kickstart in my aviation career, especially one in the Air Force, where I hope to be in the near future.
My experience at SYFC has been extremely fulfilling. It has really empowered me to do a lot of things that you wouldn't get to do in school. Those days when you're really bad days in flight, I've learned how to push myself forward to overcome these obstacles and eventually achieve my goals. I would really like to thank the club and my instructors, Mr. Bernard Ling, Mr. Simon Sim, Mr. Hai, for this excellent opportunity and for being very patient and tolerant with me. Thank you.
My journey in SYFC would not have been possible without the guidance of the instructors here, in particular my primary flight instructor, Mr. Rahman, who has always set high standards for me, ensuring that I was always constantly improving as a pilot. He never failed to show concern for me, not just for my progress in flying, but also in my schoolwork. I would also like to express my gratitude to all the instructors I've flown with for the invaluable guidance which improved my flying. Not forgetting the various support staff for planning my flights, allowing me to progress with my PPL course despite my busy schedule with school. We'll be right back.